Hey there. It's been a while since I've done a Frankenlab, I know. I've got a lot of footage that I need to process and get some videos out. I want to show you how to set up the stepper motors and go from having this thing sound like grinding glass to getting a nice smooth operating system. And then I want to do some videos and show you a lot of the customization and everything. And hopefully I'll get to that pretty soon. Work has been insane. But as a function of my job, we had to design these little electronic circuits which had to go inside of an enclosure. And when I went to the company to see about getting, you know, these little openings cut out for the cables and so forth, the price that they gave me was astronomical and the minimum quantity was much larger than what we needed to do. So it could have ended the project pretty quickly, but then I realized, hey, wait, I've got a small mill right here, the Frankenlab. So what I wanted to do was just make a little video here and show you that you don't need a big mill to accomplish some pretty cool stuff. So, you know, if you're thinking about building a milling machine and getting into CNC, don't be afraid to start small. You can always expand and do something bigger later. But anyway, let me show you this because I think you're going to find it interesting. So what I've got is for work. I've got a bunch of these boxes. I got about 200 of them. And what I need to do is I need to machine an opening here for some connectors and an opening on the other side. Well, guess what? I've got this little CNC machine right here, this Frankenlabs that we're building. And I went over and talked to Marshall over at Proto Builds. Marshall and Riley are the ones that helped me put this together. And this aluminum struts are super handy. So I put together this. I can drop the component in like that and it'll hold it fairly stout. All I got to do is just put a little pressure here to keep it from vibrating. And that gives it perfect registration. So over here, I've got my file. I hit R for run. And here's a neat little trick. It's asking me to put tool number one in, which I do. Then I hit the button. And so it's going to do the first volley here. And we're doing a couple of different passes rather than one pass, just because it makes a smoother finish. Thing is, I've told it to do a tool change, so that's going to stop the machine. Now, we're not actually changing the tool, but it gives me the chance to come in here, take this box out, flip it over, and put it back in like that. And that's all I have to do. Come over here and hit enter. And off we go. You see, I got a perfectly done enclosure here. I just dusted off. Kind of fun to do while videoing. But it's finished. Put it together, stuff it in a plastic bag, and drop it in the box. And I got a few more to do. And then project's done. So save the company a bunch of money by using this little mill. So don't think that when you're designing a mill that you need to have some ginormous machine, because this is only half meter by half meter. Very useful, and you can do a lot of cool stuff with this, especially if you start dealing with this open builds where you can configure it however you need per job. So anyway, thanks for watching. In the next video, we'll go through and I'll show you the configuration and everything. I saved all my settings so I can show you how we go through and start it from scratch, figuring out the steppers and all that good stuff. As soon as I have a chance to do it, we'll do it. I've just been really crazy busy with work. Have a great day. Thanks.